Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is JayB and today I want to show you something that I found on Speedy CTM Discord channel. A little project called USB Serial MIDI, and in my case it results in a black box with a cable, and this cable ends in an 8-port mini DIN jack. And what it basically does, it's reviving those good old two host ports that you can find on various synthesizers and sound modules by Korg, Roland and Yamaha from the mid-90s to the early 2000s. It's also got on the Yamaha QYs as well. There you go. And it's basically an Arduino board connected with a serial adapter converter, and that ends up, well, in one of those two host cables. And well, you might ask now, why am I doing this since most modules have MIDI ports? Well, the main thing I'm doing is because my little Korg NS5R has 32 MIDI channels, but only one MIDI in, and the MIDI standard doesn't allow having more than 16 channels per MIDI port. And so the only way to access all 32 ports is via this two host port. And this is the reason why I wanted to try this out and to see if I have any luck with this. I ordered all the parts from AliExpress. It cost me about 28 euros, and the build up itself was less demanding than I expected. It took me like half an hour plus a few minutes to fix some misalignments. And I want to show you how I did it. I did a light version of this that's not compatible with Roland devices because you need a few more connections for these, but it works very well with my Yamaha QY70 and especially with the Korg NS5R. And I'm going to show you how I made this right now. The schematics are all available on ValleyBell's GitHub page, and I'm going to show you how I made it, so in case you want to rebuild the light version as well. So there's four lines you need to run from the Arduino board to the MAX3232. This is number one, the transmission line. It goes from the TX, which is transmission. The blue wire goes to the input. This is marked with a little arrow. And the way back, the reception line is the orange cable, which of course goes to the RX port here. And this whole thing needs a voltage, which is labeled on the MX port by plus and minus, which goes to the 5V and the ground wire. So now the MAX3232 gets all the signals that it needs. And if we go to the other side, there's actually just three wires you need to do the connection for Yamaha and Korg synths, because Roland needs two additional wires that are kind of connected to the Arduino board directly that I did not do because I do not have any Roland synth. So basically we've got three lines, which is blue one, this is pin 5, the green one, which is pin 4, and the brown one, which is pin 3. And pin 5 does all the transmission from the board to the synths, so this goes to the arrow in this direction. The brown one, it does the receiving end, which goes into this direction, and the green pin is actually just ground or negative pole, so it goes to the minus here. And this is basically everything that needs to be done for wiring this up. So now I've hooked up my Arduino board to the computer, Mac in my case, and now you've got to program this thing to act as a class compiler MIDI device. So you go to this page, github.com/valleybell/USB-serial-MIDI, click on codes, click on download zip, and you get the Arduino project files. There we go, which is .ino. And to program this, you also need a software called Arduino IDE, which you can find on arduino.cc, and you click on software and you find the Arduino IDE. Current version is 2.0.3. You can download this for Windows, Linux, and macOS. To manage files, I recommend creating a dedicated Arduino folder where you put a folder in called USB Serial MIDI with all the files that are contained in the Arduino folder of the zip file. It's important to rename this the same as the .ino file, otherwise Arduino IDE won't recognize it. If you now open Arduino IDE, you are basically greeted with an empty screen. Exactly. So this is just an empty project that runs by default on your Arduino board, which basically is, that does nothing. And you, in preferences, you can select where you want your sketchbook to be located. In this case, the Arduino folder that I put the files into. And now you can basically open up USBSerialMIDI project by double-clicking on it. Takes a little while. There we got all the files. Then you go on select board, select in my case the Arduino Micro. And now you just click on upload and wait for it to happen. It's compiling and it's connecting to the Arduino board. This looks good so far. And it's done uploading. And that's basically it. So now if you go to the audio and MIDI setup, it's still gray. So let's just disconnect the entire thing and reconnect it. And there you go. There's the Arduino board appearing as a standard MIDI device. So now let's open up a MIDI player. Like in Mac, I've already created a synth or a module, so to say, for my Korg NS5R. So the names are a bit more human readable. In this case, I've renamed it Korg NS5R port A, B, and C. If you're working on a different system, it's actually port A is actually port 2, port B is port 3, and port C is port 1. That's just probably an NS5R thing. So I'm going to take port A here and just open up a MIDI file. Let's say the Korg NS5R Mission 2 MIDI file, and it immediately starts playing. And there's no connections aside from the port that we just installed. Let's go over there. So no MIDI connections, just the serial port that we have now. Okay, and now you can also select port B, which does the same thing on the other channels. And so on. And if you go to port C, or port 1 in this case, you can actually control the additional board that's inside. In my case, it's a Dream Blaster S2. So if I'm just taking another song here, let's take Canyon Meat. You can see no meters going up, but I can control it with the volume knob because it's using the internal Wave Blaster board. And now you, of course, can use songs that use 32 MIDI channels. Let's just open up one of the Korg SC88 demo songs, like one of my favorites, the Myth song. So, and if we now press on play, you can see that all the 32 MIDI channels are being accessed. There's one thing you need to take into consideration, or where we maybe need some help. When we're doing this under Windows, the Arduino gets detected as a MIDI device, but there are no ports available. There is a workaround for this. When you first apply the MIDI loop project that comes with the USB MIDI examples, then the Arduino board gets ports, and when you then install the USB serial MIDI project, then also all the ports are available. But as soon as you reboot Windows, the ports are gone again. So there must be some little handshake thing, I guess. I have no ideas about drivers and Windows that makes it impossible for Windows to see the ports in the first place. So if anyone who's got an idea about this is out there seeing this video, please take a look at the project of ValleyBell and see if you can find any mistake that's made in the code that can be fixed there. Anyways, that's it for this video. I hope it wasn't too long, and see you next time. Bye.